Okay, let's get into some coding. We're going to start off with the print statement, which is typically where we start with most programming languages. When you want to print output to the console to display a message either to a user or to yourself, maybe because you're debugging your code, we use the print statement in Python. It's simply the command print, then in parentheses, the string that or the message that you want to display. You can just contain it in single quotes, or it will also work inside double quotes. It's one of the unusual things about Python is you can choose either single quotes or double quotes to enclose your strings. Now, just because you can use either one doesn't mean you should go back and forth. Pick one and stick to it. Throughout this course, we're actually always going to use single quotes to enclose our strings. That's a conscious choice we have made. So we're consistent and it doesn't confuse people that half the demos are with one, half with the other. You can choose what you want, but please stay consistent. Always use double quotes or always use single quotes. But it's nice to know you can use either because you might find examples online that switch back and forth or use one you're not familiar with. Another thing you might need to do from time to time is actually ask for information from the user when you're running a program. We do that by using the input function. So with the input function, we pass in a message that we would display like, hey, please enter your name. And whatever value is passed back by the user, whatever they type into the screen, will then be put into that name variable. So it'll be stored in the variable name. And later on, we can then print that name out on the screen or use it in our code as we need to. When you're displaying output on the screen, it can very quickly become quite cluttered. So it's useful to insert blank lines in the output to make it a little more readable. There's a couple of ways we can display blank lines. One, we can just say print and provide open and close parentheses with nothing inside. That will print a blank line. Also, each print statement does put a blank line afterwards. So if you have a print hello and then you say print world, that would actually put a blank line between hello and world. Also, you can put a slash n. That's actually a special character that means insert a new line here. And what that will do is that will put allow you to put a blank line right in the middle of the string if you need it. One of the reasons print statements are really useful to coding is because we can use them for debugging. Sometimes when we're writing code, an error message pops up or the code's just not doing what we think it should do. So sometimes we'll add print statements, not because they actually make the code work, but we write print statements so that when we're running the code and we're trying to figure out where it's blowing up to see which lines of code are executing successfully and where it's failing. So in this case, you can see that I saw the message adding number displayed, then hopefully it did the addition, then I see the message I'm performing the division, and then hopefully it does division, and then I see this error message spewing all over the screen. That can help me figure out where my code blew up. So now I have a sense, since I never saw the message math complete, I know where to go look in my code for the problem. So it's a useful tool when debugging code to add and remove print statements just so you can figure out what's going on. All right, now let's go take a look at this inside Visual Studio Code.